Good morning, Kids One. Welcome back to online worship. Let's get ready for service. So if you haven't done so already, please use the restroom and get water and do whatever you need to do to get all the distractions out of the way. That way we can give our full attention and our full focus to God in these next 30 minutes or so. If you need time to do that, go ahead and pause the video and hit resume when you get back. And I'll wait for you guys. All right, now that we're back together, let's go ahead and pray and ask the Holy Spirit to help us to understand Jesus' teaching for today. Let's pray. God, we thank you so much that you are good. We thank you that you continue to provide for us always. And especially as we finished off VBS last week, we were able to see your faithfulness and your blessing upon us. Lord, we pray and ask that even today as we open up your word again, that you would teach us by your Holy Spirit that lives in us. Help us to understand the teachings of Jesus, that we may obey and live a life that is according to your will and according to bringing you glory, Lord. Be with us today, God. Would you speak to our hearts? Would you open up our hearts and our minds to receive your word today? In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So as always, let's begin our time with some songs of praise and worship to God.
Hi, Kidz One! I'm so glad you're back here today. I'm so thankful that you're able to join worship with us. Before we get started, I want you to high five someone next to you. High five! Go to the kitchen! High five! All right, now that we've done that, I want you to get your hearts ready, get your voices ready, get your minds ready to worship God. Let's get started. We're going to have a time of offering right now. So if you have it in front of you, let's go ahead and hold it actually, as if we're going to give offering like we do in Kidz One service. I still want you to remember that offering is a big, important part of worship. And I also want to remind you that you can actually send your offerings to church. So if you want to do that, go ahead and ask your parents that you want to send your offerings to church. If you're ready, let's get started.
Pray for the offering together. Lord, we thank you so much that you are faithful to us, that you are our great provider, and for all the things that we have that's good in our lives, we know that it comes from you. Help us always to acknowledge you as our provider. Help us to understand that all good things do come from you, God, and it's not that we deserve any of these things, but by your grace and by your love for us, God, you give us these good things. Help us to always be thankful for the stuff that you give us. Help us always to know that it's from you and to acknowledge you and just to use all of the things that you've blessed us with for your glory. I pray, Father, that you would help us to also to trust in that faithfulness, that you will always be there for us to provide. And I pray, Father, that you would also help us in our lives to be faithful to you, God, as you are so faithful to us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. So welcome back again to Kidz One Online Worship. I'm so glad that you guys are here with us this week. Last week, we did have VBS, as I mentioned before. And I've heard so many great things from your parents. So I received a lot of messages and emails about how great VBS was for you guys. And I'm so glad that you guys had a good time. For me, it was so evident that God is still working in us. It was a reminder of His faithfulness. Because honestly, this first online VBS, we didn't know what to expect. We did our best to prepare, but we really didn't know how it was going to turn out. But thank God and praise God that He is faithful, and He always, as always, He allowed us to have a wonderful VBS again. So thank you to everyone that helped out, and thank you for everyone who joined us in that. It was such a good time. So for those Gangnam plans that you guys have, hopefully you guys are still growing it. I saw a lot of good pictures of how much it had grown. If you guys are able to, I would like to see more of those pictures. So if you guys can this week, maybe you can take a picture of it and have your parents send it to me via email. I would love to see how your plants are growing. And just a reminder for those Gangnam plants as well, remember that it's not just to sit there and just be a plant to grow, although that's fine too. But additionally, we also want to pray whenever we see it. It should be a reminder to us to pray and ask God to help us become like the good soil, to guard the gospel in our hearts and to cling tightly to it. So I hope you guys are still praying that those plants are not just any old plant that you have in the house, but that it is a reminder for that. So hopefully you guys will continue to do that. But today, as we get into our message for today, I realize that today is actually the last week of our unit on Jesus' teachings. So today's story is going to come from John chapter 14. But before we actually get into it, it's going to be from John chapter 10. But before we get into that, let's go over our memory verse, which is in John chapter 14. Do you guys remember it? I know that it was kind of confusing because we had the VBS memory verse kind of in between, and hopefully you guys didn't forget the John 14 verse. But if you did, let me just quickly remind you. It begins with, "I have spoken these things to you." Do you remember the verse? If you do, then great. If you don't, I'll actually put it up on the screen so you guys can read it with us. But let's say this together on the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. "I have spoken these things to you while I remain with you. But the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and remind you of everything I have told you." John chapter 14, verse 25 through 26. Yes, okay. Verse 25 through 26. Great. So if you did remember it, then awesome. Great for you guys. Let's actually say it one more time because this is our last day, and I know we've also kind of had to review it since, again, the VBS verse kind of might have like confused us. So let's actually say this verse one more time on the count of three. Again, if you know it, if you remember it now, maybe you guys can stop looking at the screen and try to say it from memory. But if you guys don't know it yet, then that's perfectly fine. You guys could go ahead and read it with us together. So let's say it together, loud, clear, and together on the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. "I have spoken these things to you while I remain with you. But the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and remind you of everything I have told you." John chapter 14, verse 25 through 26. Amen. Amen. So again, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, lives within us to help us to understand and obey Jesus' teaching. And everyone who believes in Jesus, those are the people, followers of Jesus, those are the people who have the Holy Spirit living within them. And that Holy Spirit is what helps us. So today, my prayer is that the Holy Spirit will teach us and help us to understand this last section of this unit, which is that Jesus taught that he is the good shepherd. So our Bible passage today comes from John chapter 10. If you have your Bibles, please open it up to John and then find the big number 10. We're going to start reading from verse 1, so go ahead and turn to verse 1 as well. And if you guys need time to do that, go ahead and pause the video and hit resume when you guys are ready. All right, now that we're all together, let's begin reading from verse 1. It says this, "Truly, truly, I say to you, he who does not enter the sheepfold by the door, but climbs in by another way, that man is a thief and a robber. But he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the gatekeeper opens. The sheep hear his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. A stranger they will not follow, but they will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of strangers. This figure of speech Jesus used with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them." Oops, sorry. Didn't change the verse there. But hopefully you guys are following along in your Bibles. So Jesus begins to teach the people about who he is and why he came. And he does this by painting a picture of a sheep and a shepherd. Now, this picture, it might not make much sense to us regular people in the current age, in the present time, because we don't really have sheep around us, right? When was the last time you saw a sheep? I don't think I've ever seen a sheep in person. Maybe once when I was a kid, when I took a field trip to a farm. But normally, you don't really see sheep around. But back in those days, shepherding was a very common job among the people. So, in fact, many people that we see in the Bible were shepherds. Moses was a shepherd. Jacob was a shepherd. King David, probably one of the more famous shepherds. And most of the people listening to Jesus during this teaching were probably shepherds, or at least they knew a lot more about shepherds and what they do and sheep and how they respond to shepherds than we do today, right? So most likely they understood what this picture that Jesus was painting for them. But John tells us in verse 6 that the people didn't understand what Jesus was saying. Now, they understood the picture that he was painting about sheep, but they didn't understand what Jesus was trying to teach them through this picture. And Jesus was actually trying to teach them that he, in this picture, he is the sheep, and then the sheep are actually us. We are Jesus's sheep. Jesus is our Lord. He is the one who takes care of us and protects us, and we are the sheep. And if you know anything about sheep, you would actually know that sheep cannot do anything on their own. Sheep are pretty weak animals, right? So if predators come, if other animals try to eat the sheep, most of the time the sheep won't be able to fight back because they're not meant to really fight off any predators. The sheep, if they are by themselves without a shepherd, they would normally not know where a safe area is, and if animals do attack, then they will be helpless. So a shepherd is needed to guide the sheep and lead them to safe places and to protect them from enemies. And this is what Jesus came to do. And any sheep that belongs to a shepherd, Jesus says that they know the shepherd and they follow him. When they hear a stranger's voice, they do not follow the stranger because they don't know the stranger. In the same way, if you are a follower of Jesus, if you belong to him, then you know who Jesus is and you follow him only. So you don't follow anyone else because they will lead you to destruction, to danger. But we follow Jesus because we know that we are safe with him as he is our shepherd. And we only follow the shepherd, that's Jesus, whom the gatekeeper or God has let in. Right? God has appointed Jesus. He has sent Jesus to us for him to be our shepherd. And so we are called to now follow Jesus and nobody else. And Jesus goes on to explain further in verse 7. So let's actually go ahead and continue to read there. It says this. So Jesus again said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is a hired hand and not a shepherd, who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees, and the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father." Okay, so Jesus again explains that he is the shepherd. But this time he explains in more depth, and he teaches us that he is the good shepherd. So not just annual shepherd, he says he is the good shepherd. And the good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. Now, the main job of a shepherd is to take care of his sheep. First, by feeding them. And then by cleaning them. And secondly, along with taking care of the sheep, the shepherd's job is to protect them from thieves and wolves that might try to come in and steal or attack the sheep. And as Jesus says, the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy, and the wolf snatches the sheep and scatters them, right? So the thieves and the wolves are the dangerous enemies of the sheep, and the shepherd is the one that protects the sheep from these enemies. So number one, he takes care of them. Number two, he protects them. Now, because of these wolves, because of these thieves, and even taking care of sheep, it's a very tough job. Being a shepherd is a very tough job because a shepherd is put into danger when he's protecting the sheep. Because also he's not in charge of just caring for one sheep, but he's in charge of caring for many, many sheep. So sometimes these shepherds might even hire people to help him. And this is what Jesus is talking about in verse 12. This is the hired hand that Jesus is talking about. So sometimes in order to help out with taking care of the sheep, a shepherd might hire somebody, the hired hand. The only problem with the hired hand, though, the big problem is that the sheep are not his. And so when danger comes, like wolves or robbers, the hired hand, rather than staying and protecting the sheep, will be scared and they run away. He runs away to save his own life because he doesn't care about the sheep. He doesn't love the sheep because the sheep are not his. But Jesus is not the hired hand, as we see in his little story here. Jesus is not the hired hand, but he is the good shepherd. And the good shepherd stands between the wolves and the sheep. The good shepherd protects the sheep with his life because the sheep are his and he loves the sheep. And Jesus says that to us, he is our good shepherd. He is the shepherd. He is the good shepherd because when we are in danger, when we are faced with danger, he doesn't run away. He doesn't stand to the side, but he stands in the way and protects us with his life. Jesus is the good shepherd who was sent by God to save us from danger. And kind of similarly, just like we learned at VBS, Satan doesn't want us to be with God. As we learned in day one VBS, when we talked about the seed and the soil, when the seed falls onto the path, it's like Satan trying to snatch away the gospel so that we can't believe. Or even in the other soils, the rocky soil and the thorny soil, those are the more sneakier ways that Satan tries to rip us away from God, try to keep us away from God, right? Satan, his only goal is to snatch us away from God and keep us away from him, keep us apart. So in this story, Satan is actually like the wolf or the robber, the thief, right? The one that tries to take the sheep away from the shepherd. Okay. But Jesus is a good shepherd who stands firm to protect us. He doesn't run away. He is not afraid. But Jesus stands to protect us. And this is really, this teaching about the Good Shepherd is really an illustration of the gospel. The good news of how Jesus saved us from our sins. Because of sin, we deserve to die. Like sheep, we were helpless and we couldn't save ourselves from sin and death. We couldn't save ourselves from this enemy, this thing that separated us from God. But Jesus, the Good Shepherd, saved us. We deserved to be punished because we were the ones who sinned against God. We were the ones who disobeyed. But instead of us being punished for our sins, Jesus, the Good Shepherd, was the one who saved us. He didn't stand aside. He didn't run away. He didn't just stay in heaven and watch us dive into our sins and have this punishment with us because of our sins. He didn't just stay up there and watch us be condemned. Instead, Jesus came down and he took that punishment for us. Jesus stood between us and the danger that awaited us. Instead of sitting to the side, he came to the front and he took on that punishment. He took on the cross in order to save us. He gave his life to protect us like the Good Shepherd. And Jesus laid down his life for us so that we could be saved. He took the punishment that we deserved by dying on the cross and taking all of our sins upon himself, even though we were the ones who deserved to be punished for our sins. Jesus was the one who was punished instead for our sins, right? Kind of weird. And how does this make sense, right? How is it that we're the ones who sin and we deserve to be punished, but Jesus is the one who's punished instead? We're the ones who deserve that punishment because of the crime we committed against God, but instead of us being punished, Jesus was punished instead. And this is the good news of the gospel, that God didn't just stand aside when we deserved to be punished for our sins. Instead, he came to earth in human form as Jesus to be punished for us instead, to take our place, and instead of giving us punishment, to give us eternal life. And this is the good news. But the good news actually gets better. So Jesus wasn't powerless. It's not like he was helpless like we are and he had to die and couldn't help himself from dying. No, actually, Jesus had power over sin and death. And he, rather than having to die, he chose to die in our place. And he explains this also in verse 17. We already read it, but let me just put it up again and read it again. He says, "For this reason, the Father loves me, because I laid down my life that I may take it up again." He says, "No one takes it from me," that's his life, "no one takes his life from me, but I lay it down of my own accord," meaning that he lays down his life because it's his choice. "I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father." Jesus laid down his life for us, and it was his choice. No one can take his life away from him. So Satan doesn't have power over him. Sin does not have power over him. Death does not have power over him. Jesus is the one who's in control, and he has power over all of those things. It was by his choice that he laid down his life. But again, it doesn't end there. He also has the choice to come back to life again. And this is the amazing part of this good news, is that 3 days after he died on the cross, he came back to life to show us that he has power over sin, he has power over death. He died to protect us, and now he lives to lead us as our good shepherd. Anyone who believes in Jesus belongs to Jesus and now lives in the safety of his care. Our good shepherd who died to protect us is not gone. So this is where the imagery kind of breaks. Because for a sheep, if a good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep, he dies protecting the sheep. But after then, the sheep have no one to follow. But in our case, Jesus dies to protect us, to save us from our enemies. But the good thing about Jesus is that even after he dies for us, even after he lays down his life for us, he is still alive to lead us and continue to care for us and to continue to protect us. Anyone who believes in Jesus has eternal life, and nothing can take this away from us. Nothing can remove us from the love of God. So Jesus is the good shepherd who cares for his people. And the gospel is our hope. This good news that Jesus died for us to give us eternal life, but not only that, he came back to life. This is our hope, the thing that we hold on to get us through the tough times. When life gets hard, when life gets difficult, we can trust and understand and know for a fact that we are always in Jesus' care. Jesus will always be our good shepherd to lead us and care for us and protect us. Jesus is the good shepherd, and he will never leave us behind, but He will always be in front of us to face whatever danger, whatever circumstances, whatever struggles we may be facing. Jesus is always there for us because He is our good shepherd. So now where do we go from here? As people of God, as followers of Jesus, as His sheep, we now live by following Him, by listening to Him, and by obeying Him. Now that we are a saved people, we follow Jesus as our good shepherd as He leads us on. So let's go ahead and pray together. Let's thank God for this good news, and let's also ask God to help us to continue to follow Him. Let's pray. God, we thank You so much for this good news that we were so undeserving of. God, we were helpless in our sins. We deserved to be punished for our sins. And there was absolutely nothing we could do to save ourselves. But God, as the good Father You are, as the good shepherd, You didn't just stand aside to let us be punished, to let us suffer under a punishment that we actually deserved, God. You didn't stand aside, but You came Yourself to earth to bear the punishment upon Yourself, and Jesus to lay down Your life for us. God, there is no way that we can thank You enough for what You have done. Thank You so much for this gospel, this good news that we are now saved by what You have done for us. And all we need to do is believe and trust in You and to follow You. I pray that You would help us by Your Holy Spirit to continue to learn, continue to understand Your teachings, and continue to obey. As followers of Christ, I pray that You would help us to be obedient to You and to continue to be a light to this world. I pray for Your help. I pray for comfort and peace to anyone who is suffering as well. I pray that You would ease any struggles during this quarantine time as well. God, we praise You and we thank You so much for all that You do. Would You be with us this week to help You, help us to glorify You with everything that we do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So I pray that you guys will continue to live according to God's will, according to in trying to glorify Him with all that you do. I have two announcements. Number one, hopefully you guys know that today is the first Sunday of the month. So we have August birthdays. And I was actually really surprised because I was looking through the directory that we have and found that we only have two August birthdays. So I think this is like the smallest birthday month that we have. But anyways, we do still have two people we want to bless. We first have Kaylin Kim, who is turning 9, who will be going to Kidz too soon. Kind of sad. But yeah, congratulations, Kaylin. And we also have Peter Jung, who is turning 8. Peter is still staying with us in Kidz 1, so I'm happy for that. But anyways, I still want to congratulate you guys. I want to sing happy birthday for you guys. So here we go. If families, you're at home with Kaylin and Peter, please sing happy birthday with me together on the count of 3. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Kaylin and Peter. Happy birthday to you. Go ahead and blow the cake. Blow. Go ahead and blow one more time. There it goes. Bye-bye, cake. All right. Congratulations to you guys for turning 1 year older this month. I pray blessings over you guys. I pray that God will continue to walk with you and continue to help you to grow in knowledge of Him and to grow to love Him more. The second and last announcement that I have is we are continuing our Zoom meetings for small group. Small group will be at 12:30 p.m. Parents, check your emails for the Zoom link. And for everyone that I do see, I'll see you guys here. But for everyone that I don't see, I will see you guys next week. Have a wonderful week. Bye, guys.